Hi friends, I am Bhavna Sharma and you are watching MR Info Line. We have with us in the studio today Dr. Neemo Dhar, who is Dean, Faculty of Media Studies and Humanities, Manavrishna International Institute of Research and Studies. And she is the Director of Radio Manavrishna 107.8 FM. I extend a hearty welcome to you, ma'am. Ma'am has actually served the industry for a very long time. She is a seasoned professional and she has been the Faculty of Media Studies and Humanities Dean for past 3 years. Besides this, she has served the government sector as the Commissioner for Public Relations in Delhi Development Authority. She has also been the visiting faculty for media studies students. And ma'am, you have such a rich experience of media studies and you are heading as a dean for the Faculty of Media Studies and Humanities here. What would you like to say about the USP of our courses?
See, these courses are conducted by most of the universities and most of the colleges. But the difference which our course has is that there is too much emphasis on practical training. We don't limit ourselves to the structured syllabus. We go beyond, much beyond that. And this practical aspect is not only giving training or not only, you know, undertaking exercises which can expose them to the working of the media industry, but we also arrange, you know, lectures on weekly basis from experts who tell them about the real-time stories, what happens and how they work. So our basic emphasis is that our students should be so trained so that when they come out of our institute and go to the industry, there is no transition hassles. They very smoothly transfer from the academics to the industry. So our emphasis slowly increases over the years on the practical aspect of the course, and by in the sixth semester, that is third year, we send them for 3 months industrial training so that they are well equipped when they leave the premises. So this is how our course is different from most of the university courses.
And I think we can proudly say that our students come out industry ready.
Yeah, that's a fact, because see, last year we provided umpteen number of employment opportunities to our students, and you'll be surprised to know that most of our students, excepting a few who went for higher studies, they have been placed in the media industry itself.
And you don't really have to worry about a job, you get options to be there in which of the industry you want to be. Besides this, ma'am, you've been a seasoned professional and you've been in the public relations. And public relations is a very upcoming line, and I think it's a very good profession. What would you say about this?
See, PR is a profession which is becoming very important over the years. Earlier, one used to think that PR professionals are protocol officers. But now the concept of PR has totally changed.
Yes.
It is something, you know, it's a go between the organization and the stakeholders. And you orient the policies of the organization as per the feedback of the stakeholders. And this feedback and a, you know, pulse of the stakeholders is communicated through the PR professionals only. You must have seen that earlier there hardly used to be PR professionals, but now PR professionals are in almost every field. Even in educational institutions, you find PR professionals. So it is a profession which is going up very fast, which has avenues, which has chances, which has scope to expose a person to show his best.
And ma'am, you have been the Director of Radio Manavrishna 107.8 FM, and it's a very popular medium for information and entertainment. What would you say about it?
See, Manavrishna, I feel Radio Manavrishna is slightly different as compared to many community radios in the area. The reason is that here the programs are so structured that they reach almost every strata and every age group of the society. We have programs which are women-centric, we have programs which are educative in nature and, you know, revolve around various aspects like diseases, like health issues, like some other addictions, like tobacco misuse and all that, tobacco use and all that. So these programs, education, entertainment, topical issues, these all make it a mix of what a person requires and almost everyone requires. So that way I find this community radio is serving the community in a very big way.
And ma'am, I'm right now sitting with a woman who's empowered. She has been a seasoned professional, and of course, ma'am, when you're a powered woman, indeed, you know, you would like to give a message to the rest of the women who are actually listening to you right now. What would you say to all our audience?
See, I will say first, we should not think about a women worker or a man worker. We are all workers. were employees, so this tag should go. The women can give their best only by trying to excel in the field in which they are working. We should not think that since I'm a woman, I should have certain privileges, I should have some. No, we are a worker like any other worker. So the best USP for a woman to succeed is to give one's best capability, efficiency, efficacy in one's work, and then excel in the world work in which you are doing. Secondly, one should never try to give up the inquisitiveness which in a person has, because that is what makes you work and progress in the future. So I will feel every woman should try to excel in whatever work they are doing, whether it is X, Y, Z, that does not matter at all. So that is this, that is the step to progress. And thinking that I am a woman and I have certain barriers is totally uncalled for.
So all the friends who are listening to us right now and watching us, follow your passion, and then I think for success, sky is the limit. Ma'am, it was a pleasure being with you. And actually, thank you so much for sparing your valuable time and speaking to all of us.
Thank you and welcome anytime.